Hey guys, I hope you're all having an amazing day. So today I'm going to be giving you my top tip for every single legend in Apex Legends. As always, if you guys do go on to enjoy it and want to see more guide type videos just like this one, then be sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and leave a comment with your favorite legend in the comment section below. And without further ado, let's jump straight into the video. Alright, first up we have Bloodhound, whose main asset is definitely their ultimate ability. Using the ultimate is pretty much like going Super Saiyan, as you get increased movement, faster scans, and rumor has it, greater sexual appeal. Therefore, you're going to be wanting to use the ultimate as much as possible by charging it with ultimate accelerant. My top tip for Bloodhound is to always carry at least one or two ultimate accelerants to ensure that you can get your ultimate ability at any given time. Sadly, having one of the best ultimates in the game comes at a cost, as it also has one of the longest cooldowns in the game of 3 minutes, meaning it is imperative that you're wanting to be a dominant Bloodhound player that you carry ultimate accelerants at all times. Next on the list is Thicky Bicky Gibraltar, and my top tip for him is to always carry a strong bubble fight weapon in your secondary weapon slot. For your primary, go for your life, whether it be an R301 or a charge rifle, may God bless your soul. But as for your secondary, you are going to benefit greatly from carrying a weapon that is good in bubble fights. Some of my favorites include the Mastiff, Peacekeeper, or the Prowler. Now on to Lifeline, and just because you have a revive drone doesn't mean you should use it at any time. If you throw it on your teammate without thinking about their positioning, you might end up just getting them killed. So wait until they are behind cover before you put your drone on them. Also, the animation of throwing out her drone does take a second, so don't throw it on a teammate while you're being shot at from close range, or it will get you and your team killed. As for Pathfinder, unless you can 100% guarantee a kill, always save his grapple as a get out of jail free card. Pathfinder's grapple is arguably the best repositioning tool in the game, however, you only get one charge at a time. By using your grapple recklessly, you will ensure a fast death, so be smart and only use it when necessary. On to Wraith, and I think it is very, very important that you try your best to break line of sight when phasing. While a tactical does provide you with increased movement speed and temporary invulnerability, the enemy can still see you and consequently follow and beam you when you come out of it. Therefore, you should always ensure that you use this movement speed to try and break line of sight and make it to a safe position where you can heal. A neat trick that you should always remember for Bangalore is that you can actually use meds while also shooting out smokes at the same time. Use this to your advantage and maintain your temporary cover from the enemy to finish off your heal. I can't even count the amount of times this has allowed me to get off a heal and as a result saved my life. So definitely keep this in mind. Next up is Caustic, and my top tip for him is to place gas traps next to doorways and not on them, as you might block either yourself or your team. Instead, place them next to a door in a way that if an enemy walks through, they will be hit and you and your team can still move in and out freely. If, however, you're getting pushed and need to fall back to that building and heal, for example, then move them back to the doors and lock yourself in. Next is Mirage, and for this legend, I think that it is very, very important that you aren't in the line of sight of the enemy when using your decoys or your ultimate ability. If the enemy sees you throwing out your decoys, it will be obvious which one is you. Furthermore, you light up when using your ultimate, so either way, you will be caught out. Make sure you slide around a corner or behind cover to ensure maximum bamboozles. When used correctly, Mirage's ultimate should pretty much guarantee a kill one-on-one, assuming that you hit your shots. My top tip for Octane is similar to Pathfinder's in the fact that you want to use Octane stims and jump pad defensively rather than offensively, unless you are 100% sure you can either secure a kill or position yourself in a good spot. Octane stim is loud and takes health, and his jump pad is also extremely loud. By using them without thinking, you are mindlessly jumping into a fight with less health than your opponent and a massive audio cue giving away exactly where you are. So unless you are confident you can secure the kills, then run in with your team like a normal human being and use these abilities to get out of sticky situations during a fight rather than before. My top tip for Watson is this really neat trick. For those of you who don't know, you can put a node down on the opposite side of a door Then when an enemy walks up to the door, put another one down on your side, and the electric current will connect the two, breaking the door down and stunning slash dealing damage to the enemy, pretty much guaranteeing a kill, assuming that you hit your shots. This is a really cool trick that I would definitely recommend getting used to. As for Crypto, I would definitely recommend getting in the habit of throwing down his drone early to activate your EMP remotely and push in with your team. Recently, they buffed Crypto, providing some more autonomy to his drone, making it so that you can leave it in a spot and activate the EMP remotely. The drawback to using Crypto's ultimate was always that you were slightly behind your team when pushing, but not anymore. Activate the EMP remotely and secure some easy kills. On to Revenant, and I can't stress this enough. Don't just throw down Revenant's ultimate because you have it. Make sure to have a look around for nearby enemies and place the totem in an advantageous position that is easy to defend. Due to the not so recent nerfs, Revenant's ultimate pretty much notifies everyone on your side of the equator when you use it. So you have to be very, very careful. Now we have one of my personal favorites, Loba, and I know this seems to be a recurring theme, but being completely honest, Octane and Pathfinder you can kind of get away with, but I'm telling you, do not use Loba's bracelet aggressively unless you are chasing down the last guy on a team or in a very advantageous position. Once activated, Loba's tactical enters a lengthy animation, making you a super easy target. If you throw a bracelet remotely near someone who is alert, you are going to get one clipped. Her bracelet is best used as an escape or repositioning tool, not as a replacement for Octane's jump pad, so please heed my warning. Onto the defensive machine, Rampart. Make sure to place your ultimate on cooldown when you have already used up most of the ammo, rather than holstering to ensure that you don't pull out an empty Sheila in a gunfight. While this will put your ultimate out of commission temporarily, it will ensure that it is ready and fully charged for the next fight. Next, we have Horizon. When you are taking a Horizon lift, take it from the edge rather than the center to ensure maximum mobility when going up it. If you jump on at the center, you'll be lifted up in a straight line with minimal left to right movement, preventing the enemies from one clipping you. Take it from the side and you will sway back and forth, making you much harder to hit. If you are 100% confident that you aren't going to get beamed, then you're more than welcome to take it from the center for easier aiming. However, most of the time, you're going to want to take it from the edge. Fuse. Don't substitute weapons for abilities. While extremely tempting, don't just spam all your grenades, clusters, and ring of fire all at once just to leave you with nothing when the enemies dodge them all. Fuse's kit is one of the best in the game for zoning and pressuring the opposition. Start out with your guns, maybe a grenade or two, and then save your abilities for when you have dealt a lot of damage and the enemy is on the back foot behind cover. This will get you some easy kills, trust me. Next up is Valkyrie. When playing Valkyrie, the high ground is your greatest weapon. In opposition to other legends like Horizon and Pathfinder, who also have vertical mobility, Valkyrie can take and drop the high ground multiple times in a short duration during a firefight. Use this to your advantage. Take the high ground, shoot down on the opposition, and if they take it from you, drop, bait them into dropping, and then take it back. Valkyrie has arguably the greatest vertical mobility in the game, next to Horizon, and I highly suggest that you use it. Seer. When using Seer's passive, make sure that you use it with your weapons holstered rather than while ADSing with your weapon. This will allow you to scan around much faster than if you have your weapon out. While rotating or pushing a team, make sure to always have those hands up scanning around for enemy players. Personally, I have this little habit I've developed of slide jumping, scanning while in the air, and then continuing running. That way I can quickly scan for enemies while still staying on the move. As for Ashe, her ultimate and tactical ability pair together really well. When trying to escape from a team, make sure that you throw down your tether at the end of the portal to prevent enemies from following you. That way, if an enemy follows behind you and takes your portal, they will instantly be tethered, taking damage and making them much easier to fire back on, or just tethering them down so that you can get some extra distance. My top tip for Maggie is similar to Fuse. Rather than throwing out her drill early and getting maybe 10 to 20 damage before the enemy moves out of the way, Wait until you have the enemy backed into a corner and use the drill to move up on them, or simply finish off their remaining health while they're trying to heal behind cover. My most important tip for Newcastle is to use the mobility and durability of your mobile shield to its fullest. Need to push a team? Throw it down and move forward as cover. Need extra cover for a res? Throw it down. Need to further reinforce your wall? Chuck it in front. Need it to pay your taxes? It can honestly probably do that too. This thing is great. You can even play it like a Gibby bubble as a last stand. My point is, Newcastle's mobile shield has so much versatility. Don't let it go to waste. As for our second last legend Vantage, I highly recommend that you only use her sniper if you have at least 2 bullets in the chamber. This is because your first shot will mark the enemy and hit them for 50 damage, and consecutive shots will hit them for 100 plus damage on the marked target. If you are finishing off an enemy that's low on health, then go for your life, but as a general rule, I definitely recommend using it with 2 or more shots available. On to our 23rd and final legend, Catalyst. My top tip for Catalyst is about the placement of her spike. For those who don't know, Catalyst spikes have a glowing orb in the middle that can be shot at close range to eliminate them. If you position your spikes in a certain way behind a door, the spikes will protrude outside the door. However, the orb will remain inside, making it much more difficult to destroy. Alongside her passive ability, which allows you to reinforce doors, you can make building fights much more advantageous for you and a pain in the ass for your enemy. All right, well, there you have it, my top tip for every single legend in Apex Legends. As always, if you guys enjoyed, make sure you do leave a like and subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you all in the next one. Take care, everybody.